That's all right. But if I take it out and someone actually pays me, don't get jealous. Most black men do. I talk a little bit slow, but only because I take Prozac. So, you wanna know why I take Prozac? I went to the doctor last month, and I said, man, my thoughts are racing. I'm really depressed. I feel down. I just can't get out of this zone. He's like, man, you know I just can't give you Prozac. That's not how this works. You gotta give me a reason. I said, well, here it goes. So I take my phone out, show him a picture of my mother-in-law. He says, damn, dude, why didn't you commit suicide yet? And they say, suicide can't be fun. There she's like, oh, that wasn't funny. That's a suicide joke. That's just mean. You don't talk about that. That's horrible.
You don't talk about that.
1/3 Italian. See, that brings a smile. I was getting ready for this show. I only had like an 8-hour notice. But it's awesome, and I love doing it. And I was trying to get ready for this show, and my wife, she has this Doberman, and it's a full-blooded Doberman. You all know what Doberman is?
Yeah.
All right, you black folks do, because, you know, they're police dogs. We know what Doberman is, we run the most of them. My wife, she has this Doberman in this train, and it stands about this high. And she's always going, and I hate it. I don't know why white people do this. It's so damn annoying. It's my baby! It's my baby boy! Come here, my little baby! You're so cute! It's my baby boy! I'm just trying to wait for the show. I'm like, hey, God, just please have a half an hour of silence. It's a half an hour. I just need to throw this shit together. Just let me do my thing. She's like, no, what's wrong? I said, honey, that's it. I'm tired of this shit. Just shut the hell up. Just shut up! I said, let me tell you why. Because if that dog's your baby, I'm calling Murray, because there's no way in hell I'm calling. And she screamed at me, and she literally tells me, she goes, you know what? Being married to me is a lot like raising a goddamn child. I'm like, well, but you never complain when I get the munchies. Hell, it comes down to the gospel, let me tell you. I get filled with the Holy Spirit. I really speak in tongues. I'll tell you about that at the end of my routine. I was actually a preacher, but not now. Okay, let me tell you about my childhood. And these stories may seem like, you know, he's making that up. No way no one's had a fucked up life. Let me tell you about my grandma. When I was 10 years old, I had a Bible-believing grandma, a God-fearing woman that totally believed in wrath. She did not spare that rod at all. You get that, right? I mean, when my grandma says, sit down, shut up, what do? You sit down, you shut up. Well, I was 10 years old, I was feeling rebellious. My grandma said, sit down, shut up. Watch your cartoons. And she's in the kitchen, she's sweeping, and she's one of those women. I mean, she spanked you, she grabbed a wooden spoon, the spatula, she just happened to have a broom handle. And I decided to push my luck. I said, no, grandma! That's all it took. My grandmother literally came in the room, and I'm not making this up. She's swinging that broom handle. She blacks and blues my arms. She's hitting my arms. I'm going, no, grandma, my arms, stop! And I'm kicking, and I'm on the couch, and I'm rolling. She's hitting my legs. No, grandma, stop! And my back's all black and blue. My arms are black and blue. My legs are all black and blue. And I'm crying. She finally stopped. See, let me tell you about my grandma. Because she really did go full Mathia, and that was a good old day. I survived it. I'm okay. I'm totally normal, right? At least I think so. But yeah, she actually did that. Now, this is where the fun part of the story begins. My mom comes over to pick me up, and I'm crying on the couch. I'm She's like, what's wrong, sweetie? What's wrong? Why are you crying? I said, Grandma, hit me! She hit me with the broom! She wouldn't grab! She's like, oh, did you sit down, shut up? She doesn't like a lot of noise. Why don't you just sit down and shut up? But she hit me, Mom! She hit me! She hit me! I'm looking all black and blue all over! She said, oh, quit your crying. We'll get more on our food stamps now because of it. It's a welfare joke. I am not politically correct. If you wanted that, I'm the wrong guy. Look at me. I mean, damn, I'll put up the dick joke if you'd say. All right. A little bit more about my childhood. Let me tell you about the sex talk when I was 12, my dad gave me. And I'm not making this up. My father came to me. He handed me a penthouse, a playboy, and a hustler. Sits down because my dad hated sex talks. And he looks at me, he hands me these magazines to take a good look. He says, the women in this magazine are sex objects. Women in real life are to be respected. Good talk, son. Enjoy the magazines. That was a sex talk. That was a sex talk from my father. So I thought my parents are gone. This is a true story. And I find the true stories are the best. I thought my mom and dad left the house. So I get the magazines out. I'm looking at them. I'm looking at the Genesis. You guys remember Genesis? I know you do. Classic porn. Yeah, I like you already. I'm into midgets, by the way. I love midgets. It makes me feel like I'm having sex with a small child. I love it. But yeah, so I get this magazine out, and I'm looking at her. My mom walks into the room. She looks at the magazine. I'm doing my thing. She looks at me. Looks at the magazine. Looks at me. She literally goes, put that away before you put your eye out. Now, my mom, I love her. I got an awesome mom. She's very straightforward. Also a Christian, but she's very straightforward. And she's very innocent. She always says what she means. Anyone else with mothers like that?
Oh, yeah.
No bullshit. It's cut to the point. Me and my wife, we go over to the house, and she hands my wife a bag of tampons, just like this. She says, here you go, Peggy. This Peggy's my wife. And she goes, here you go, Peggy. These are too big for me. And I'm like, Mom, I don't need to see this. I don't need to see that. She says, what? I said, you're my goddamn mother. I don't need to know that. She said, what's wrong? What do I do? I said, Mom, you're basically telling me that my dad is not my dad. Because there's no way in hell my dick is that small. True story. Yeah, being a comedian, my mouth gets me in a lot of trouble everywhere I go. I just didn't think my wife would ever find it on my sister-in-law, that's all. Oh, I did talk about Tom's earlier, didn't I? I'm getting up to that subject. Man. So being married, I've been married 16 years. Now, I love my wife, we have our up and downs, but I found out, being married 16 years, there's times that when my wife cooks a meal, I swear I'd get better food in prison. I don't know for sure, but I think I would. Not to mention, being married for so long, I actually think I would get more sex in prison. So this brings up a good-looking guy, okay? Every single time my wife wants to hold out, I'm going to be like, yeah, I'll just steal somebody. Yeah, I'll get me a bitch home here, really. Where am I going from here now? Let's see. See, you gotta keep going up, right? It's kind of like a penis. You gotta just keep it going upwards, right? You can see more erectile. You get that, right, man? Absolutely. Oh, man. I wrote a song a while back. But before I get to that song, you hear it. I'm trying to cut down on my smoking. I'm down to 3 months a day. I am. I think it should be living. I love weed so much. I wrote a song about it. And this is my song I wrote, and it being Christmas time, I'm doing a Christmas show here coming up in Mansfield, a dirty Christmas show. So I decided to write my own version of these songs. This is my version of Old Christmas Tree. And it's Old Christmas Tree for Pete's sake, you know? You always ask people where the trees are, right? You know what I mean? Hey, go to New York and pull over in the park. Hey, bro, where's the tree? And they look at you and be like, they're right there. You don't see that tree right there? It's horrible. It happened to me in New York. And I swear, if you're white, they think you're the police. Now, I don't know. I just met you tonight for this lovely lady right here. And what's your name, by the way?
Jennifer.
She's another comedian. And I love her. I love New Rose Battles, by the way. I enjoyed our conversation earlier. It was awesome. She looked at me earlier, true story, and she actually said to me, she said, you're not in the KKK, are you? Because of the whole scar things and the white head, didn't you?
Yeah.
And what did I say to you? I said, only fear. I said, only fear in the Black Panthers because I really love to lick pussy.
Oh, see, I didn't hear it. You should have said pussy eating. I'm
also, when I smoke weed, I feel like I'm more intelligent. Do you get the, you know what I'm talking about? It's like you have deeper thoughts. It slows it down. You know what I'm talking about, right? I won't watch superhero films. I won't, because I start thinking of the craziest shit about superheroes. I do. When it comes to superheroes, for instance, Superman. You're watching Superman, you're smoking a blunt. You pass it. You look at Superman, you're thinking, God damn, with all those superpowers. If Superman masturbated, and he shot his load and landed in North Korea, would they accuse America of firing a nuke? Like Trump needs a reason to start a war. Come on. Hey, speaking of Trump, I wrote a song about Trump. Y'all want to hear it?
It's a good song.
Oh, yeah, I do that. You're right. Thanks for reminding me. I'll do that, then I'll do the Trump song.
Okay.
The Trump song's about Silent Night. I'm going to kill your childhood with these two songs. Oh, Christmas weed, oh, Christmas weed, you are so special to me. When I wake up, I hold you close. When my wife comes home, you comfort me. Oh, Christmas weed, oh, Christmas weed, you make everything so peaceful.